different. So two more examples, but now we have, they look a little different. They have, in the previous video, they were just ending in one number.
Oops.
Right, they were just ending 0000 and then one number. And so these aren't like that. So we have to follow this requirement. One number behind the decimal in the final answer. And so, when it did something like this, we would just count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we would say 6 times 10 to the -7. So notice that this fits the requirement of one number behind a decimal. What that means is that it has to be, let's say, 6.0 times 10 to the -7, and not, like if I add another zero here, that doesn't change the value, right? But if I do that, then I'm counting 8, and so I would place a decimal there, so I would be at 60 times 10 to the -8. So these two have the same value, but only this one is in scientific notation, or the proper scientific notation, because it has one number behind the decimal. Right, and so let's not make this super confusing. And let's do some simple examples to kind of make it make sense. Right, so the first thing, what you're gonna do is you're gonna stop right when you hit your first non-zero number. So my first non-zero number will be 9. So right after I pass 9, I stop. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I've passed 9. I've taken 4 steps. So imagine you take this decimal and you move it and you put it over there. So now it's 9.56. And so I need to turn this number to the original. So I have to make it smaller. So it's times 10 to the -4. And so the same thing with the next one. 1, 2, 3. 4 is the first non-zero number. I stop right there. So I'm going to move the decimal there. It's going to be 4.2. 1, 2, 3. I took 3 steps. I need to make this smaller to get back to my original. So I put times 10 to the -3. And so this is how you do proper scientific notation, or the actual way to do scientific notation. And so now we'll just keep doing more.